63 degrees right now. Pat, a quick forecast.
Well, very warm day today, and even some more thunderstorms possible. And then we start to cool off tonight and overnight and through tomorrow, maybe a few snowflakes. So, big change on the way.
Thanks. We got some Rod Stewart or ACD tickets coming up from Q95 in a matter of moments. We'll squeeze that in later. This is the Bob and Tom program.
This portion of the show brought to you by...
Oh, perfect.
Before I start doing this, I want to tell you guys.
Do it now.
I love you.
You got 20 seconds.
J.D. Byrider, you're drowning in bills, credit problems mounting. Go to J.D. Byrider during their tax sale. They've got $10 million to lend. J.D. Byrider has for immediate loan approvals on cars. All makes, all models. J.D. Byrider, got your credit, got your cars. Greenwood and Avon, west of 465 on Rockville Road. That's J.D. Byrider.
Nice.
Good morning. This is the Bob and Tom Show.
Hi.
Seamless.
I love you guys.
Stunned.
I really love you guys too, Chick.
I love everybody.
Are you reassessing your life?
I love everybody in this room.
We could just catch up briefly. This all started when someone faxed us this news report about Bonnie Booth. Now, we just spoke with Bonnie. She shot her toe off purposely because she had a very painful callus on it.
Well, I think she was trying to shoot off the callus,
not her toe.
Right.
Well, she said she put the shotgun right on her toe and fired it.
But I don't think she figured that it would shoot off the toe.
Okay, now, she might have been slightly...
inebriated.
Yes. According to the account here, this is from the Muncie, Indiana Star. Hospital officials reported that Booth had a blood alcohol content of 0.42%. Now, I have since received a fax from a police officer.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And he points out here, in reference to the story of the female who shot off her toe, a 4.2 blood alcohol content would be coma or near death for some people.
See?
I would think.
But there are some experienced drinkers who can register that high and be only slightly tipsy.
I think she had a tolerance.
Slightly?
I think she's probably built up a tolerance over the years.
I wouldn't want to speculate.
Oh. Yeah. Wow.
Bonnie said she was, according to this account, drank a gallon of vodka and three beers, grabbed a shotgun and went in her backyard.
How old is Bonnie?
14.
Now, Bonnie is 38 years old.
Mm-hmm.
38.
Sounded a little older.
Mm-hmm. She did sound a little older.
According to this account, she is 38. So we may want to talk to Bonnie later today. I know she was having some medication, but she's in the hospital. The toe, I guess, is gone. But
she seems pretty lackadaisical about it.
She might be still listening, so if the Demerol doesn't work, try mixing that with a little Valium in your drink.
Will you stop it, please?
I didn't know you were a physician, Chick.
Oh. Don't dispense professional advice. It's incredibly illegal.
I'm speaking from experience.
No.
I had that,
Chick.
And it's very, very good.
Don't do that, Chick.
All right.
Yeah, she really didn't seem to be very upset, so
no.
I'm glad she's...
She seems very even-keeled.
Yeah, she did. Can you imagine how hungover you would be? This just happened last night.
Me? No. I would not be hungover.
It happened last evening at 6 o'clock in the evening.
I would be dead.
Yeah. And she's not even...
I don't have that kind of tolerance.
I don't either.
And I hate vodka.
I'd be throwing up.
Yeah, I hate vodka.
I love vodka. But she did have a couple beers, too, Bob.
So. Well, you know.
Mm-hmm. I forgot to ask what kind of beer she had. We'll have to call up and find out.
I bet it's not that new beer.
Speaking of beers, there's a new beer in the market. Pat?
Yeah, there's a new beer.
Your husband and I have quaffed a few together.
Mm-hmm.
I just enjoy talking to him. Maybe he'll have one of these with me. I'm sort of involved in this beer. They sent me a sample case. I really enjoyed it.
Hey, beer drinkers. Do you find that your beer not only fills you up, it binds you up? You need a beer that will help you loosen up. Introducing the beer that not only tastes great, it packs a mega high-fiber wallop. It's the first beer that's also a laxative. We call it Shats. S-H-A-T, apostrophe S. Shats.
All the cats tip their hats to the man who's drinking Shats. The man who needs some fiber in his brew.
Shats beer.
When all is said and done, we're not yet number one. But Shats is always number two.
Hi, I'm Phil Throne from the Shats Brewing Company. Pour yourself a Shats and see why it's making a splash all over the country. Shats, the laxative beer. Shats is brewed with the highest quality hops and barley. Then we add our secret ingredient, whole kernel corn. Not too much, just a pinch. Every Schatz beer is fortified with 12 essential vitamins, so you're always guaranteed a good, healthy Schatz. Schatz is available in the 6-ounce little squirt or the 64-ounce big lager. And every Schatz is tapered at one end, so your can won't slam shut. We here at Schatz are saddened by the recent passing of Adolf Schatz, founder of the Schatz Family Brewery, better known as the Old Brick Schatz House. In fact, Adolf loved his beer so much, his last wish was to be interred in a giant vat of Schatz. So come on, when it's time to take a load off, crack open a Schatz.
You will say, hooray, cause relief is on its way. No more irregularity for you.
Schatz beer.
Give a Schatz a pop, and soon you'll hear a plop. Schatz is nature's perfect brew.
Schatz.
Don't just take any beer. Take a Schatz. And for you teetotalers, try our new high-fiber non-alcoholic beer. We call it O-Stools. O-Stools. Sample one today. And don't forget Schatz Light, Schatz Dark. And for those with diverticulitis, proctitis, and polyposis, doctors direct them to try new Schatz Red. Schatz Beer. A division of Frigimal Industries, Flushing, New York.
Why must you be obsessed with such things? See?
It's a new beer.
You know the weird part? He actually did research on that.
I'm sure he did. You looked up those diseases, didn't you?
I called my consulting physician.
Good move.
We were gonna end it by saying, look for the Schatz logo, the red stool on the can, but we thought that was a little rough.
Really? Well, thanks for sharing.
I sure am glad you didn't say it.
The rest of the song was certainly PG.
Because if you would have said it, that would be really disgusting.
Where are we doing sports?
Well, yeah, we just started, actually. Let's see. Where are we here?
I have no idea.
Utah beat Phoenix last night at America West, 110-87. Karl Malone had 28. John Stockton, 16 points, and he also had 11 assists. Reggie Miller canned a three-pointer with 6 seconds left in overtime. Indiana Pacers dumped the Boston Celtics, 122-19. Reggie had 39 in the Pacers' third straight win.
How'd they go in overtime if they only had 19 points?
What? I said 39. What do you mean? 122-119.
Oh, 119.
Oh, did I just say 19?
Say that was one hell of an overtime period for the Pacers.
Wow, did they move?
Oh, damn, I'm sorry.
Never seen shooting like this in my life, Slick.
I can't believe this.
100% from the three-point line.
101 points in overtime. Amazing.
4 minutes, 100 points.
Leave him alone. Go ahead.
121-19 is what you said.
You need a good, healthy Schatz beer.
It was 122-119.
My mistake. Okay, well, we got that cleared up.
The Lakers.
Would you like?
I'm going to talk the rest of the sports cast like Sir Carol Simpson.
You're going to pronounce every word?
I'm going to pronounce each and every word.
Every syllable?
The Los Angeles Lakers used 27 points from Cedric Ceballos. Two bounces.
You know what her problem is?
What?
She needs to drink a good, healthy Schatz.
Lakers, never mind. Lakers 114, Knicks 96. New York missing the injured Patrick Ewing and J.R. Reed, who was serving the first of that two-game suspension. Grant Hill's 21 points, 10 rebounds, led the Pistons past the Sacramento Kings 93-78. The Kings have lost 11 straight. Rockets will not have Clyde Drexler in the lineup for a while. The kicker out anymore. The veteran guard will miss 5 to 6 weeks of action after undergoing arthroscopic surgery yesterday. Drexler suffered cartilage damage in his right knee, evidently had a callus, and he was trying to shoot it off.
He'll be ready for the playoffs.
UK puts its number one ranking on the line tonight when it visits Auburn. The Wildcats took over the top spot in the AP poll yesterday, ousting UMass.
Did you see their new uniforms? Did you catch it this weekend?
Wrong button.
What was that?
I was trying to hit the crickets. Sorry.
At the crickets.
Have you seen their new denim uniforms?
I've only heard tell of them.
They're very different.
The UK?
Yeah, I saw them
over the weekend. The problem is the colors look...
The problem is the lighter blue, I guess. Yeah. It looks like North Carolina.
Maybe they shouldn't
They're a little darker than I thought they were going to be.
Maybe they shouldn't have stonewashed them.
Then they'd be a little stiff.
They'll get lighter each time they
Yeah.
Jacques Vaughn scored 17 to lead number 3 Kansas over Missouri, 87-65. 15th-ranked Syracuse blew a 20-point halftime lead, but rallied to trounce St. John's, 92-79. And number 24, George Washington beat Xavier 81-77. J.J. Braid's four straight free throws put the Colonials ahead to stay. Today is the day we could find out where Wayne Gretzky will skate the rest of the NHL season. The all-time leading scorer says a trade is near. He'll meet with the owners of the Los Angeles Kings today. The great one has been mentioned in trade rumors for weeks, and according to ESPN, the Kings could announce a deal as early as today, sending Gretzky to the Blues for three prospects. Kings president Bob Sanderman says the team's owners have not made a decision whether to trade Gretzky. Winnipeg 4, Los Angeles 3 last night. Colorado beat Anaheim 3-2, and San Jose beat Montreal 7-4. Dallas Cowboys now lost three defensive starters from last year's Super Bowl championship team. The latest to leave is linebacker Dixon Edwards. He signed with the Minnesota Vikings. The Arizona Cardinals are given a five-year contract to cornerback Aeneas Williams worth $17 million. Free agent quarterback Neil O'Donnell may consider returning to the Pittsburgh Steelers. Steeler fans responded, yay. O'Donnell's been courted by the New York Jets, but his agent says he'll wait for another offer from the Steelers and maybe continue talks with the Rams. And William the Refrigerator Perry will try to come back with the London Monarchs of the World League. The former Bears and Eagles defensive tackle sat out the 1995 season. Baseball, Jose Canseco back in the Boston Red Sox camp after missing a day because of a legal problem. Huh. He also missed the team's first full squad workout last Tuesday, but he did get a chance to take part in the charity golf tournament.
Well, of course.
And scorpions are the talk of the San Francisco Giants and California Angels campsites in Arizona. The old Cactus League Giants shortstop Sean Dunston stung.
What are you trying to whistle?
What are you whistling?
Wind of change.
Wind of change?
Oh, by the scorpions.
Oh.
I don't think that's it.
It isn't?
Yeah, you hear it.
It goes,
la, da, da,
la, da, da, da,
da, da. Isn't that Wind of Change?
Yeah.
Sean Dunston was stung twice on the right shoulder. Should be back at practice today.
Do you think these were pranks? Do you think the guys
See,
were putting...
It sounds like
put
a prank
put scorpions
to me.
In their beds and
yeah.
stuff?
Yeah.
I don't think it's pranks.
Angels players...
I bet it is, Bob.
...warned to check all
Come
their
on,
belongings.
It's really
are,
cold there.
These
I
guys
bet
are professional baseball
are all...
players. They're screwing around.
I bet they're running inside because they're cold.
Pitcher Jim Abbott found a scorpion in his shoe.
You know, some of these guys, yeah. you know, Barry Bonds finds goes another bad case of crabs. Jesus.
Woo-hoo!
You know, these guys have all had everything.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you meet a baseball
they
player.
More than
you sure you take peroxide, pour it on. If it bubbles, you go south.
Whoa, baby.
Do the math.
I was right.
Do you have the Andy Griffith Show theme song?
Sounds better when I
Bob. Bob, do you have the Andy Griffith
Sounds
Show?
Sounds a little better when I whistle it.
I don't have that, I'm sorry.
You don't have the Andy Griffith?
I like the Scorpions.
Someone took the CD.
They're German, you know.
Yes, they are.
See, that's what I love about this place. People just walk in and grab whatever they
Here's
want.
Here's a funny CD. I'll take it home.
Never
yeah.
return it. Yeah.
Next contract, we get our own studio. Every day at 10, lock the door. See, we're going to do a real funny bit here and play that this goes right into the Andy of Mayberry theme very well.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it does. Is it time for that special
yes,
moment?
Yes, it is.
It's time for Sports Oddity.
Dateline Camden, New Jersey. The provost at Division III Rutgers Camden, New Jersey, the losingest team in college basketball history, decided to drop the men's sport Monday after 108 consecutive losses.
Oh, no.
Oh,
wow.
Quoting here, I think 4 years is a reasonable amount of time to try to win a game.
I agree with
that,
you.
That quote from Provost Walter Gordon. There are times in life, he says, that situations when you should give up. The Pioneers, 0-24 this season, their fifth year in a row of uninterrupted losing. Their last win came when they beat Ramapo, New Jersey, 74-73 on January 18th, 1992. Gordon made the decision despite the objections of athletic director Wilbur Pony Wilson, one of the team's three coaches since the streak started. I was against it, Wilson said. That is not the solution to the problem. I hit that again. We've got another sports oddity.
It's time for Sports Oddity.
Dateline, New Brunswick, Canada. A hockey coach at the University of Moncton in New Brunswick was suspended, and several of his players could face criminal charges after they assaulted a referee with their sticks and fists. After an overtime loss to the University of Prince Edward Island, referee Brian Carriger speared twice in the groin with a hockey stick. Others punched him in the head and midsection. A team official also was seen uprooting a metal net mooring and hurling it through the rink's protective glass.
Man, those Canadians take their hockey very seriously.
I guess.
No one was hurt.
Oh, yeah.
And that's...
Except for the ref.
Yeah. What about the referee?
It's time for sports. And
we need a close.
Oddity.
You have one more?
No, that's it.
No, you should, that should say, this has been sports.
maybe no, that's a good suggestion. Maybe next time we'll have
I know I give you too much advice. I promised I wouldn't anymore.
He listens to one thing I say in 10 years, and that's it. This has been Sports Oddities. Okay.
Write that down.
I'm writing it down. Christy!
Salt Lake City last week banned all after-school clubs from its high schools as a way to prevent the formation of a club for lesbian and gay students.
Did you hear about this?
Wow.
Yeah, I sure did.
This was a big story. Yeah. These students wanted to have a gay club, and they said they couldn't. So they went to court, because in the court decisions that allow to have these clubs, there was a big thing about them earlier because they wanted to have religious clubs, and they said they couldn't have those. Well, now they can have those. So to get away from this problem...
The school shut down all
clubs. This problem is not a problem at all. They shut down all clubs, and all students marched. They did a big march just last week. But what I was thinking of, they could have solved this if they'd done what was the primary means of dealing with this when I was in high school. You just name the gay club a different name. You simply call it the drama club. And that way,
there you get your club and
eat me.
I was in the drama club.
So was I.
Yeah, Tom.
Damn it.
Okay.
So you were the guy. Huh?
I was in the stage crew, the heterosexual.
You lifted stuff. Okay.
Sure, stage crew. You know, we smoked cigarettes and, you know, carried ladders around.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Fine. Well, thank you very much, Christy.
Yeah.
Oh, my.
Do you want to?
No.
What?
Nope, I don't want to do anything.
I wanted to get Bonnie back on the phone here.
No,
more about shooting her toe off.
I think she told us everything
Bonnie
she's got to say.
Bonnie is being medicated, and I think she needs her rest.
I think we're walking a fine line with Bonnie.
I think she needs to recover from
hey,
that hangover.
We are merely reporting the news.
That's right.
We have a chance. This is a big news story.
Yeah, it's so big. It was picked up in the Muncie paper.
Can I leave the room if we can?
Now, can you imagine how funny it would be if we'd go right into? See, I wish we could do that. Except, see, they allow other people. I'm telling you, next contract.
I know.
10 o'clock.
Our
store locked.
I know.
We've got
many studios.
I'd like my own building.
Your own building.
See, now I am for that, so we wouldn't have to walk through the Shysterville up there. That'd be good. It's like Hooverville.
Hey, how you doing? You want to wear?
I'm sorry. We'll take a break.
Parking lot back here would be the best.
Private parking.
Yeah. I agree.
What did you say on the air?
Nothing. Nothing at all.
We're going to take a break and come right back. This is the Bob and Tom Show.
On the next
morning.
Good morning. Right now, let's give away some stuff, okay?
All right.
We'll take caller 9 at 239-1095 for... either a pair of AC/DC or Rod Stewart tickets.
Your choice.
You pick them. AC/DC at Market Square Arena March 7th. Rod Stewart at Market Square Arena March 21st. Your choice. Ninth caller, 239-1095. We're doing this all day on Q95, so listen for Jay and Dog and Gunner and everybody to be giving away tickets today, okay?
All right.
This is the Bob and Tom program. Welcome back.
Hi.
We did have a...
Hi, Pat.
Hi.
How you doing?
Good.
Nice to see you.
You too.
Yeah.
You know, Pat, I don't think you heard this song.
What song?
What song, Tom?
We had a... you weren't here. I know you were going to the last... We have a new song I'd like to play for you.
Oh, really?
This is a good friend of the show, John Wing.
Mm-hmm.
And a great comedian, a Tonight Show veteran.
That's right, you weren't here.
Mm,
and we'll enjoy this together. Now, you're, of course, a happily married woman, beautiful daughter.
Mm-hmm. But before you were married, I'm sure you had your share of gents.
No. Let me handle this, Bob. I think I can get through this without getting into trouble.
Oh, he's so much more tactful.
Yeah, he is. So how many guys did you dump, Pat?
Bob has a way of...
There were occasions...
You can't discuss these things with Bob.
There were occasions when I'm sure you might have had an unpleasant parting with someone. I'm not necessarily going to... I don't know any details.
All I know is that there was furniture involved.
All right.
See, Pat, I told you. Let me handle it.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Comedy is a blunt instrument when used by the wrong people. What I'm trying to say is...
All right, I'm
maybe,
sorry.
Pat, let me back up here. Maybe you had a friend...
Okay.
Who had an unpleasant encounter.
There you go. See?
A friend my ass.
Shut up,
up, Bob.
God, I'm trying.
I'm sorry.
Pat is
just
quick,
call me the blunt instrument, okay?
As quick as he's throwing the dirt in, I'm trying to dig out.
You are.
I'm digging as fast as I can.
Great job at it.
This is a song. This
about
is
a friend of mine.
And
you dumped.
Now this is from the male perspective.
Okay. Uh-huh.
And you might have felt this way, and I just want to.
No,
see
I know he did.
Fine.
My friend's boyfriend might have felt this.
I can't dig any harder, Pat. He keeps pulling the dirt in. I keep digging it out. I'm trying. Okay. This is our good friend John Wing. I think he's actually introduced here.
It's a little love song I wrote some years back. It's actually a sort of a breakup song. I'd always dedicated to all the wonderful women who treated me like a load of crap over the years. And it's a little love song.
All right.
Woke up this morning and you were gone. Found a note, it said so long. You said this love would last our lives. I hope your face breaks out in hives. I hope you die a painful death. I hope you choke on your next breath. You screwed me up, you done me wrong. I hope you die before too long. Hope you have a heart attack. I hope your breasts get really slack. You were my girl, but now you're not. I hope you die, I hope you rot. I don't want to be your friend. I only want your life to end. You're back in town, someone else's gal. I hope you drown in the love canal. I hope you die a painful death. I hope you choke on your next breath. Screwed me up, you done me wrong. I hope you die before too long. I hope you die before I end this song. I hope you die. I really, really hope you die. Die, 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 die.
Wow.
And die.
Thank you very much.
Terrible. I don't think anybody really feels that way, do you?
Oh, no, not at all.
Not about you.
No, not about you, Pat. You're so sweet.
What we meant, Pat, was that maybe you had a friend who experienced an unpleasant breakup like that.
Yeah.
So don't take that personally or anything.
No, not at all.
No.
Okay. Just wanted to play that.
10 guys probably just drove off the road.
I'm digging. I am trying to dig out here, Bob. I've been really working hard.
No help. He's never been
no,
a big
no,
help.
Doing
I
my
know.
Best
yeah, you
to try to salvage,
you.
salvage the show. Coming up in a few minutes.
He's an official member with Tom Petty. A lot of people don't know that.
In the commercial break.
Coming up in a few minutes, the band Del Amitri is going to be stopping by and playing some real music for us.
Do you know who Del is, Pam?
No.
No one's named Del. The name
Never
of the band.
Met him. Oh,
fine.
Excuse me.
Great. Now we're going to get off to a good start with the guys. Which one's pink?
Which one's
him?
Which one's Floyd?
Which one's pink?
Which one's Mr. Pink?
Yeah. Looking forward to having these guys on. They've got some great records, so we'll look
indeed.
Forward to seeing them in person.
Oh, they're here.
Are we going
They'll be here in about half an hour.
Oh, no, I feel really bad.
Okay.
Are we going to try to? Are we going to even make an attempt to get back into news at this point?
Why?
I don't know why. No.
Took care of that one
Where are we? Are we at DEF CON 35?
35 coming up, yeah.
Because we did have a special request. Let's play this. It's a short
song. Go
ahead
song. And play it. Go okay,
ahead. What is this?
That's all right.
Well, do you want to read this news account?
Oh, the news, the big news story?
Mm-hmm. This
yeah,
was.
Are we doing news now?
Well, I think kind of.
Yeah, kind of just.
Let Pat just do this first story, then we'll take a break after this song.
This was kind of interesting. Sent to us from Muncie. A Muncie woman somehow was not seriously injured Monday night when she shot her foot, apparently to remove a callus. Muncie police reports stated that Bonnie Booth, 38 years old, drank a gallon of vodka and three beers, then grabbed a 410, is that how you say it?
410.
410 gauge shotgun, went out into her backyard and shot at the callus on her foot about 6 o'clock Monday night.
Now, we spoke to Bonnie.
Mm-hmm.
About a half hour ago, and she's doing fine. She's in the hospital. The tip of the toe is gone.
Yeah.
Above the nail, apparently.
Big toe.
Save on nail polish.
Mm-hmm. Come on.
Gotta look at the bright side.
There's always an upside, isn't there?
Sure.
Mm-hmm.
She apparently was quite intoxicated. She indicated that she had downed an entire bottle of vodka
and three
beers at least.
And her blood alcohol content.
0.42.
That's hefty.
We had a request that's not related to that story, but we thought we'd play it anyway. This is these are our good friends Pinkard and Bowden on the Bob and Tom Show.
One, two, three, four. She's got tattoos on her backside, a Harley Davidson in the den. She's got an open door for the Marine Corps. She's looking for a few good men. She walks out to her mailbox in her see-through pink tube top. If it wasn't for her biker friend, somebody would have called the cops. And she's a
trailer park woman.
She's a mobile home princess. She's the queen of manufactured housing. She's a trailer park woman. She's a mobile home princess. And me, I'm the trailer park king. She spends her nights in a strip joint, doing some exotic dance, in an out-of-date pair of platform shoes and worn-out spandex pants. Her kids still live with her mother and her brother who's unemployed. She always calls me Elvis, but she knows my real name's Floyd. And she's a trailer park woman. She's a mobile home princess. She's the queen of manufactured housing. She's a trailer park woman. She's a mobile home princess. And me, I'm the trailer park king. She's got a bad reputation. She's the talk of the neighborhood. Maybe her place ain't Graceland, but the furniture's just as good. I often look through her window when she's getting dressed inside. She don't mind, she looks up to me, 'cause I own a double wide. Got a concrete block foundation, she admires it so. She always comes a-knockin' whenever there's a tornado. And she's a trailer park woman. She's a mobile home princess. She's the queen of manufactured housing. She's a trailer park woman. She's a mobile home princess. And me, I'm the trailer park king.
Pinkard and Bowden.
Yes, indeed.
A great tune. Trailer Park Woman.
A classic.
Tune written in part by our good friend Tim Wilson, who will be our guest down the road a piece. Well, good morning. We're going to take a little break and come right back with some more news and stuff. Also coming up, as I indicated earlier, Delamitri for some live music in our studios. This is the Bob and Tom Show.
Howdy.
Scattered showers this morning, maybe some thunderstorms. Highs today about 70. Currently at Q95, we have 64 degrees. Going to get cold tonight, though, down to 30, so the heat wave, such as it is over. Congratulations to Kevin Rich. He chose to go to see Rod Stewart. We got Rod Stewart and AC/DC tickets all day on Q95.
If you want my body,
and you think I'm sexy,
come on and grab my
feet. I used to think he was sexy. No more.
No.
Excuse
more.
Me. I'm sorry. I blacked out. This is the Bob and Tom program. We're back.
I might have to go at any moment.
Where?
I do not want to hear an explanation
of
why. I
have to leave the room.
Time for the news.
Quiet. Been eating the Lucky Charms?
Excuse me.
I'm having a little
quiet.
Trouble. Let's have a little trouble.
Maybe you didn't hear us.
Okay.
Now.
Oh, wait a minute. We can do a beer song about it, but we can't.
Right.
That's the technical explanation.
Okay.
yesterday, we asked you to fax us. We've received hundreds of faxes. Our topic, what to title our spring album project. We received many great suggestions. We're leaning toward one of our own ideas, though, which is Factory Air, which is a slang term that is a reference to a particular anatomical attribute of some women.
It is an attribute.
It's
a desirable quality.
In which, when viewed...
Consider that perfect legs.
When standing up in a bikini... There's actually air at the top of their thighs between their legs. That's called factory air.
And right under the...
and then...
chick.
We also considered calling the album Nasty Stuff.
Nasty Stuff.
No, you can't use an S in there.
Mm.
It's got to be Nasty Stuff.
Nasty Stuff.
No, then...
No S in
That's it.
See, I don't know how you spell that. Then it looks like
N-A-T-H-Y-T-H-U-F-L.
You're damn right.
See, then you're never going to get any publicity.
And now the news.
And Bob and Tom's Nathy Thump.
Yeah, that was available. At
you can get enough.
Factory Air is the way to go. Just let's just do that.
Okay, well, in the process of discussing that, we also mentioned the possibility of calling the album Taint.
No, we never mentioned that.
No, I don't think that was ever... That was
well, somehow the topic of...
I agree with my friend.
Elephantiasis came up.
That was my fault, because I saw the tape over the weekend.
We're not calling it.
That's a friend.
Elephantitis.
How about we call it...
It's elephantiasis scroti.
That's a friend.
See, elephantiasis scroti, which we discovered from our medical dictionary, is a disease, and I have a photograph of it here, Bob.
The guy was three times as big as that.
Yeah. I didn't see the photograph.
Oh, my God.
The guy was three times bigger than that in the video. At least four times bigger.
It looks like
what is that?
It looks like the man has a watermelon in his jock strap, literally.
Big
watermelon.
Can you cure that?
Yes, you can. I spoke to my doctor last night.
What'd he say?
They
cut him off?
Naturally, he was at his computer, and within a matter of moments, he was able to find
the diagnosis and how to take care of it.
Mm-hmm.
So how do you do it?
Was he on the phone?
I don't know. Was he available?
Oh.
Don't know.
Who is that? Who is that man back? That's not our producer.
I don't know.
That's Cookie.
Who the hell is that?
Try calling that number, see if he's there.
Which I hope it's the right number.
This is how we get in trouble. We got engineers producing. See?
At least he can work the phone.
Oh, that's true.
Now, this is from a medical journal. The abstract, the short version of the medical case here. It says, we report a case of a 37-pound scrotal leiomyosarcoma. Or leiomyosarcoma.
Ooh, you want to stay away from the omas, don't you?
I would think.
Oh, my.
The literature is reviewed and the presentation, diagnosis, treatment, and survival of patients is discussed. Now, how about this? The opening statement. An 80-year-old man presented with complaints of fever and chills. The guy was 80 years old.
With a 37-pound...
Yeah. Blood cultures demonstrated... Blood cultures. First thing they do, you think.
I'd say you'd be able to notice just in the inseam.
They should be taking measurements, fitting them for a pair of pants. That's what they should be doing.
Man.
They want to help.
You're going to have to dress right from now on.
Just have to.
You have to dress wheelbarrow-ish.
Now, according to this, the patient, it says physical examination revealed a massively enlarged scrotum, which the patient stated had been enlarging progressively for 5 years. So he turns 75, gets a lump.
Wouldn't you notice?
Turns 80, decides to go to the doctor because he has...
A 37-pound...
Lump.
Yeah. The patient was ambulatory, meaning he could walk around, although with some difficulty.
Yeah, no doubt.
Or it means he had to ride an ambulance all the time.
Mm-hmm.
What would he wear?
Guessing sweatpants a lot.
He couldn't have put sweatpants on
probably
with that
a big
thing.
Flowing...
I'm figuring...
We're getting to those
shorts with the crotch cut out.
I know the man I saw, the... Tribal gentleman had on like a big tablecloth.
Sure he did.
He just put like a tablecloth around.
That's your muumuu.
It was a muumuu. Yeah. That's
it. If you're going to want to wear a dress, it's got to be floor length.
That's right. Yeah, you can't wear it.
Well, this even at that because it was so massive that it didn't cover.
And his friend was carrying them, wasn't he?
Yeah.
That's a friend. Mm-hmm. That's what friends are for.
I mean, that's 37 pounds. This other guy's must have been in the hundreds.
Does it give any cure information there?
He's wrinkling his nose, though,
I didn't get to page two.
Don't get to it, then.
Go, baby, go.
We don't have it, I don't think.
I don't think I got page two.
They didn't fax us the whole thing.
Good.
Oh, okay.
I wanna see.
You want to hear about excision of the mass?
Yes.
No.
Were they?
No, they just cut it.
It's pretty complicated.
Good, I don't want to hear about it.
No, I don't want to hear
it. But there was no evidence of recurrence.
But they can cut it out and he'll be okay.
They did a CAT scan a year later.
Uh-huh.
So this gentleman obviously lived a
Christy's cussing.
Long life.
Tell her to stop.
I didn't cuss. I belched.
Sorry. Well, let's just move on. I wanted to thank the person for clearing that up since we got on the topic.
Christy.
Dude, that was you.
Come on.
Man. I'm sorry. Could we move on now? Some news headlines, please.
A U.S.-backed statement has been issued by the United Nations denouncing Cuba's downing of two planes belonging to a Cuban exile group. That reflects the general feeling of the world community against the downing, but there's little support for retaliatory U.S. sanctions. Some of those sanctions imposed against Cuba by the president yesterday include suspend all charter air travel from the United States to Cuba, request to Congress to enact legislation providing compensation to the families of the victims, seek a compromise with Republicans Republican lawmakers on a bill that would dramatically expand economic sanctions already imposed on Cuba, expand the reach of Radio Marty, the U.S. propaganda network throughout Cuba.
Hey, good morning.
Cuba.
Hi, good Marty here. Hi, good morning. You know, Radio Marty, Cuba's very, very nice and really cool. Okay.
Buenos dias. Yo soy Marty.
Uh-huh.
Yo soy.
Tengo couple.
Que hora es, Marty?
Hey. They're going to tighten travel restrictions on Cuban officials living or visiting the United States as well. In other news today, polls are opening in North Dakota. They'll be followed by South Dakota and Arizona for their GOP presidential primaries. Bad weather could hamper turnouts in all three states. Surveys show tight races between Bob Dole and Pat Buchanan. Speaking of the weather out west, in Las Vegas yesterday, they got their first measurable snow in 6 years. About an inch fell on the ground at mid-morning. However, temperatures climbed to 44 degrees, and it melted pretty quickly. But
Sid,
they did let the kids out of school
play.
The
payoffs in Vegas were unbelievable.
Yeah.
Sid, bet white. There is no white.
Yeah, we haven't had a winner since the last time it snowed.
Testimony scheduled to resume in Michigan court.
Do you guys know what this is?
Is that Bonnie?
No, that's an Iraqi divorce. Just letting you know.
Next case.
Next.
Oh.
Well.
I just thought I'd stop by briefly.
Mohandas K. Gandhi.
You were talking about...
You missed Pat.
You sure did.
Take your foot off that chair. I want to smell it later.
Oh, my God.
Wow. Disgusting, Mohandas K.
Wow. You were talking about tumors. I once knew a... man who had to have a 100-pound tumor removed.
Ew.
It was really? Benign. He did fine, yes.
Where was the tumor?
It was down there.
No, it wasn't. Yes.
But sometimes people are obese and fat and don't realize they have these terrible tumors.
That's right.
Yeah.
Bob, do you know what looks good on 5 pounds of fat?
No, what?
A big, stiff nipple.
I've been telling you, it's just fat anyway. You guys wouldn't listen to me.
I think if we all hold hands, if we all hold hands right now and pray, we'll be okay.
I have to agree with you.
Well, I have to go. Before I do, you probably have missed me lately. I've been watching a lot of television, watching this American presidential campaign for the Republican nomination.
Have you?
Yes.
Didn't realize you were a political
guy.
Oh,
yes, yes, yes. Bob Dole.
Mm-hmm.
Bob Dole's my favorite. You
see your man?
Might have heard that his campaign staff was shaken up just yesterday.
Yes, it was.
But I'm afraid his candidacy is dying.
Oh, is it?
Yes, I saw some polls yesterday. The most positive thing voters are saying about him is, doesn't he look natural?
Oh. Wow.
He does have the same facial expression for everything, doesn't
yes,
he?
Yes, I'm sorry. So, well, time to go.
Well, thanks, Mo.
Oh,
it's been a pleasure.
Thank you.
Okay. I got to sniff that chair for a minute. Just get out.
Thank you so much.
Why don't you
go
visit Bonnie in the hospital? You two have a lot in common.
Mm. Thank you very much, Christy.
Testimony is scheduled to resume today in a Michigan court in the assisted suicide trial of Dr. Jack Kevorkian. An attorney say the case could reach the jury this week. Lawyers in O.J. Simpson's wrongful death suit say O.J. could wind up his deposition testimony today. The end could be coming just in time.
Yeah,
yesterday, apparently, O.J. swore at an opposing attorney when quizzed about how he cut his hand after Nicole was murdered.
I thought he had an answer for that.
And now the end is near.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
A juror who says he hadn't heard of Snoop Doggy Dogg before the rapper's murder trial could end up on Snoop's next album. Snoop threw a party last week to celebrate his acquittal on murder charges, and half the jury showed up. Newsweek reports that juror Randy Maddox performed a rap called Cut the Dog Loose. Snoop says he thought the rap was sort of dope, and he may put it on his next album.
Now, that's good, right?
Yeah, dope is good.
Sort of dope?
Sort of dope is good.
Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow.
I don't see any jury tampering there.
No comment. Well, let's see. I'm the guy in the Snoop Doggy Dogg jury got a record contract, so... Okay, so he's guilty.
Three teens were arrested in Billerica, Massachusetts. I have no idea if it's... Billerica?
Belarus, can you do the fandango? I think it's... Lightning, very, very
how about Billerica?
There's a pinama.
Can you do the fandango? Just asking.
Don't you dare.
I don't know the lyrics.
Don't you dare sing what you wrote 2 years ago.
All right, I'm sorry.
Billerica, Massachusetts.
Wait a minute,
where three teens were arrested after they...
What did you write 2 years ago?
You don't want to hear it.
Oh, no. Yes, but I do.
No, let me just do. Here we go.
Oh, we're getting a note. For a copy of this note, send $5 to Merkel Press. And
I do believe in one. Like, Scaramouche, Scaramouche.
There's a...
I'm sorry.
Well, I didn't get
Never
to
liked
hear.
That tune. Could we move on? Where is it? Belarus?
Billerica. In Billerica, Massachusetts, three teens were arrested after they videotaped themselves ransacking a house and bragging about it. Police said, and I quote, this is Police Inspector Frank McKenzie, they weren't the sharpest tools in the shed.
Mm-hmm. I guess we did.
A little homespun advice there.
Homespun. Yeah.
I like that. How nice.
A Long Island woman will have to come up with a better story next time she decides to miss some work. Karen Bowman of Smithtown, New York, told her boss she was locked in her car by robbers and was trapped all weekend in the trunk. Her car was found in a bank parking lot yesterday morning where employees heard Bowman banging on the trunk lid. Police popped open the trunk but didn't buy her story. Detective Thomas O'Hare says the lack of any bodily waste in the trunk tipped officers that the woman wasn't coming clean, so to speak.
Well, she held it.
Bauman admitted to making up the tale as an excuse for not returning to work after lunch on Friday.
Ooh.
Wow.
A little tryst, I think.
Wouldn't but I have then, the flu but, work better?
But first of all, to actually...
So next time...
To actually lock yourself in your trunk to cover the story.
Yeah.
How bad would your job have
good.
To be?
I guess no if, you're, joke. If you're trying to plan your own crime, you have to...
You have to
sort of
you
bring,
have to poop in the trunk. I guess in order for them to believe it.
Wow.
Jeez.
Sort of a BYO.
Mm-hmm. And thanks to some high-tech engraving, the dearly departed can go to the next world with a very personalized message. Yves Poirier has been creating headstones for Quincy Memorials in Boston for the last 15 years. He says recent developments like laser engraving have revolutionized the headstone business. He says some of his more unusual requests include gravestones with beer cans, marijuana joints, and dancing elephants.
Well, they look like dancing elephants.
But the thing is...
Oh, no, no, those are probably hippos.
Poirier even created one marker for a Sox fan who died waiting. His epitaph read, "Never saw the Red Sox win a World Series."
And never will.
No, not anymore.
And what else did it say on Buckner's grave?
That'll be handy for the evening news sometime in the next 50 years when they win one.
Oh, yeah.
Well, thank you very much, Christy.
That's
we have...
disgusting.
I know it is. We were... This is a photograph that was sent to us,
Tom.
Bob,
can I tell you something? If you can convey this photograph over the airwaves on the radio, you will. I mean, you already
You will
are,
be a master of the watercolors.
May I see the photograph?
You will take a step up in my book.
Yeah,
and
me
will
too.
Be,
I can do this.
May I see the photograph?
No.
Before
yes.
we describe
no.
it?
No.
No, not before he describes it.
I must put right. it into context.
Okay, let me see if I can paint a picture.
Yeah,
he had a news. We had a news story. Earlier about a woman.
Muncie, Indiana
lady who shot off her toe on purpose because she had a callus that was mm-hmm. bothering her. We, in fact, spoke to the woman about an hour ago.
Bonnie
her
Boone.
Name is Bonnie. She is fine. She will recover.
Yes.
It was reported in the newspaper, in the news account, that she had, in fact, downed approximately a gallon of vodka.
And three beers.
She had a blood alcohol level of 0.42. I mm-hmm. speculated mm-hmm. that she probably was not drinking Stolichnaya or Absolut.
Probably
some,
not.
Some of the high-end vodkas. Mm-hmm.
Don't know.
Who knows? Who's to say?
Don't know that.
I don't know the
woman. We're only speculating.
That brought up the topic of Absolut vodka, apparently, in the mind of one of our astute listeners.
Mm-hmm.
They took that occasion to send me an apparent parody ad. I don't know where this ad appeared. I have not seen it prior to today. As you know, Absolut is famous for its very clever advertising campaign.
Yes, they are.
They have commissioned some of the finest painters, for example, in the United States, to do paintings of each state. They did all mm-hmm. 50 states. They've done some great work.
Didn't they do the
great
Absolut
billboards.
Profiles at one time?
Yes, mm-hmm. they've done great. They had the one with an Absolut skiing, where you see the Absolut
right.
Aspen, whatever it is with the skiers. Very clever company. I'm assuming this is not one of their ads, but in fact
parody.
Comedy parody. That's just my guess.
Mm-hmm.
It shows a largely naked woman.
Mm-hmm.
And in her right hand, which has very nice nails, have you noticed that?
Yeah.
She is holding what I would say is probably a fifth of Absolut
mm-hmm.
vodka.
It is a fifth.
Mm-hmm.
You can't really tell because the half the bottle is not visible in the photograph.
All right.
because it has been
strategically
placed.
Yeah.
Thank you. The woman, did I mention she was mostly naked?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. She's holding the bottom of the bottle.
From the waist down? Did he mention that?
She's naked from the waist down. That's correct.
Yeah.
Part of the bottle is hidden. I won't say where.
All right.
And the caption?
The caption is... now, can I read the second word of the...
No. Okay. No, what's the second? I forget what the second word was.
Bob?
Yeah, I think you can read the second.
Check. Do not...
Are you nuts?
You cannot
put your finger.
Cannot go by what
okay.
Says.
Put your finger on the button.
The second.
No.
The
put
second
your finger
word,
on the button, Bob.
No, I won't
do
say.
Do not say the second word.
The second word is a slang term for the private area of a woman.
All right.
Quite frankly.
Gotcha.
And the caption is absolute. See. And here is the photograph.
Oh my God.
No, you I don't can't
think,
say
I don't think
no.
That's
no.
I don't think that's in an.
You want to grab a bottle off the shelf?
No.
You want to?
You want to shove a bottle?
No, I don't want.
Have the absolute people seen this?
I doubt it.
You could snatch a bottle off a shelf.
Right?
Yeah.
Now they have absolute citrone, do they not?
Yes, yeah, so I love absolute.
Perhaps this
citrone.
Would have been funnier if they put absolute vinegar.
Or maybe. Don't they have a lemon?
A little lemon. A lemon wedge?
A little absolute lemon.
Well, that's what citron is, absolute lemon.
See, now, I have always liked that lemon wedge on a rope, and there are people that wouldn't let me do that.
I think that's very funny.
People who like to dine.
We're going to take an absolute break right now. Yes.
You know, who's the woman who has the real expensive paint out now?
The real expensive what?
Martha Stewart.
Yes.
Yeah. You know, she just got divorced.
Yeah. That was a nasty divorce, too.
Yeah, well, her husband refused to, you know, take the lemon with him down there. The lemon wedge was a little much.
He refused to eat out, is what. He would not have dinner outside the home.
We'll take a short break and come right back. This is the Bob and Tom Show. Bet you won himself some tickets to Rod Stewart. We got Rod Stewart and AC/DC tickets all day. Listen for them. This portion of the Bob and Tom Show brought to you by...
Andy Moore Ford. Moore Ford's know-how, service than you'd ever expect from a new dealership in Plainfield.
Hey.
Andy doesn't want to pay the taxes, so he's really offering low prices. Moore Ford is easy to reach, just a few minutes from the airport, west on US 40. Do you really get more for your money at Moore?
Yes.
Andy Moore Ford. Andy Moore offers this riddle. What's the difference between spinach and a booger?
I don't know what.
You can't get a little kid to eat his spinach. That's Andy Moore Ford.
Did Andy offer that?
Andy offered
Andy
that
offered
joke.
That up, huh?
Well, thanks, we'll say Andy. Goodbye to Andy. That'll be the end of the commercial. Good morning. This is the Bob and Tom program, and we're going to talk about sports briefly with Chick McGee. We have some guests coming in.
Yes, we do.
The band Amitri will be here in a few minutes. They're going to set up some stuff, do a couple tunes live. Looking forward to that. But first, in the world of sports.
Morning, sports fans.
Bob, Tom, Christy, Marco.
Chick.
Reggie Miller canned a three-pointer with 6 seconds left in overtime. As the Pacers dumped the Celtics 122-119.
Okay.
Miller scored 39 in the Pacers' third straight win. Longest active playing streak in the NBA is still alive. A.C. Green might have lost a couple of teeth when he was elbowed in the mouth in Sunday's game against New York by that quality individual, J.R. Reed. But
he's going to do a Gap commercial now.
He was able to play. He was able to play 68 seconds in last night's 110-87 loss.
Super.
To the Utah Jazz.
He was fitted with a mask.
It was a Green's 785th consecutive NBA game, third longest in league history. History. Lakers used 27 points from 27 from Cedric Ceballos.
Huerta.
To bounce the Knicks, 114-96. Boy, I wish I knew what Huerta meant.
We found out what it means.
New York was missing the injured Pat Ewing.
A garden,
J.R. Reed. Is it garden?
I don't believe it's garden.
It's something very innocuous, though.
Yeah.
Although it sounds filthy.
USA Today, there's three different ways of asking where the toilet paper is.
In Mexico?
Three languages.
Oh.
In sports, or what?
I believe it's in the business.
Some kind of
in the
business, of course.
In the money section. No, I read that first, of course.
Of course. Why would the...
How am I doing?
How am I doing?
Is it an ad for United Airlines, by any chance?
It's right up there at the top, Tom.
Grant Hill had 21, 10 rebounds. Pistons passed the Kings last night, 93-78. Sacramento's lost 11 straight.
That's the airline, the guy...
Another
serving card.
Suggestion for the name of the spring album faxed to us.
Hmm.
If anyone can explain this to me, I'll give you $5.
All right.
Ready? Name of the album. Pope Hat Races.
Pope Hat Races. Doo-dah,
doo-dah. Pope Hat Races, sing the song. Oh, the doo-dah day.
Do the chorus in Latin.
I think the Pope Hat
Domingo
Races.
Domingo
I'm ready. I know how to do it, and you're going to owe me $5.
All right. I owe you $5 from something.
I owe you more than that.
I owe you my
We've
life.
Always talked about the different types of hats that the drivers wear after they win.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
So they switch hats, and all of a sudden it would be the Pope Hat would be one of those that goes on there. So you owe me $5.
I thought it makes sense.
Pope Hat Races.
By the way, you're correct, Mark. I didn't notice this, the top of the business section of USA Today, and right in the middle there, I missed it, business travel tips.
Mm-hmm.
They have a business travel section, apparently. I don't typically read this part of the paper. Right there at the top, it says how to ask for toilet paper in three languages. In Spanish, papel de escusado.
Ah.
In French, papier hygienique. Mm-hmm. Then in German,
where's the toilet paper?
Closet paper.
You will give me toilet paper now.
Now, they don't have this, but I know what you do in Russia. Russia, you just go...
USA Today.
It's softer than the Russian paper. I take USA Today. Yes, thank you very much. I love the business section, especially get green on.
Yeah, as we say, does the ink stain?
Who cares?
Ooh.
Well, get ink on your hands when you read the paper, don't you?
Christy,
the purple section.
No, you girls and your obsession.
Do you get ink? Ink on your ace.
Oh, did you hear what he just said?
I know, it's sickening. You know.
They're ganging up on me. Yep.
As we should.
Kentucky.
No, you shouldn't.
Oh, Kentucky.
My old Kentucky home.
Kentucky woman.
The sun shines bright on my old Kentucky home.
Great song.
Kentucky woman.
Remember that day I hit my head, thought I was Neil Diamond? Kentucky puts his number one ranking.
Now, great. We were talking with Dick Vitale.
Kentucky and Auburn tonight.
Actually, Mark and I were talking about this a couple days ago. This article in Sports Illustrated. I thought it was a pretty good article.
About Rick Pitino.
Well, cover story.
I think it depends on what you're... I think that if you're a type A person yourself... kind of hard-driven and very much into what you do for a living, I don't think you find any problem with that article at all. Now, there are others that have found a problem with it because of the way he supposedly treats people around him and doesn't spend time with his family and doesn't really particularly care what his wife thinks.
Mm-hmm.
But, that's kind of a given to succeed at that level. There's very few guys that aren't like that. Mm-hmm. I didn't think anything of it.
But don't blame the article. I mean, I think it's a well-written piece, certainly.
Yeah, I mean, certainly.
These guys probably go home just to sleep, and that's it, right?
Well.
Most of the time?
This time of year.
Now, when your hero was coach of the Washington Redskins.
Joe Gibbs, he slept in his office like 5 nights a week out of 7. Slept in his office.
Can you imagine?
24 hours a day.
No. Especially in our office.
And you know what? Richie Pettibone never slept in the office. Norv Turner's starting to sleep
either
in the office.
Neither
like
did Rod
Dow. If I slept, neither did Rod Dow. Buddy Ryan never slept in the office.
If I slept in my office, I'd have a lot worse problem than the scorpions.
Of course, you know, I've been in the office, his office. It's a very nice office. I mean, it's not.
Oh, Joe Gibbs?
Yeah, he's got a big, overstuffed leather couch.
He used to have.
No,
but if you're his wife, how long do you buy that story? I'm staying at the office again tonight, honey.
Well,
aren't you sinister? What are you suspecting? That he's out at the suburban Virginia strip clubs? Is that what you're suggesting?
Well, maybe if she came in wearing nothing but shoulder pads and knee pads, there'd be a little action.
Yeah. Nothing but X's and O's, baby.
Millions and millions.
Not want to be married to a coach. Mm-hmm. It'd be tough.
Oh, I'm sorry. Chick, back to you.
All right. Jacques Vaughn had 17 to lead number 3 Kansas past Missouri, 87-65. Dickie V did that game. 15th-ranked Syracuse blew a 20-point lead.
But they came back.
But rallied to trounce St. John's 92-79. And number 24, George Washington, beat his Xavier. Xavier, the Muskies, 81-77. J.J. Braid, 4 straight free throws, put the Colonials ahead to stay. In the Walter Reed Medical Museum near... Oh, maybe we should do the sports oddities for this.
Get an outro to this?
Yeah, well, we'll see here. I don't know what it says.
I'm digging the sports oddities. Yeah. The new feature, Chick McGee Sports.
Momentum is the key to that.
Oh, absolutely.
Sure, you're
right in with the...
It's time for...
Thank you.
Sports Oddity!
Couldn't you have Pardo do this? Because now it goes right back into your voice.
In the Walter Reed Medical Museum near Washington, D.C., a man's scrotum removed from a guy with elephantiasis is on display in a vat of formaldehyde. It weighs about 40 pounds and is about the size of a large basketball. Hence this sports connection.
I gotcha.
Does it say Voight on it or something?
John Voight.
It says here, quite the display to see before lunch.
Mm. Where is that on display?
Walter Reed Medical Museum.
The Walter Reed Medical
Museum. This has been Sports Oddities.
Oh, I'm glad you had someone else do it. Then.
See, there's a different voice.
Sure. Same. Nice job.
Wow. That's a
it's not really dynamic. But I think it really fits.
It really
he sounded
does.
Depressed that it was over already.
That's it!
Yeah, well,
too bad.
Today's the day we could find out if Wayne Gretzky becomes the St. Louis Blue. NHL's all-time leading scorer says a trade is near, and he'll meet the owners of the Kings today.
He'll be listening to our show.
ESPN reports that the great one is going to be a Blue before the day's over.
Kings don't have any money.
Winnipeg, Colorado, and San Jose win in the NHL last
night. They're not winning either.
Morning, Bob and Tom show.
Yes, hello, Bob and Tom.
Yes.
Harry Testicles.
Hello, Mr. Testicles.
Must be Greek.
Yes. I'm the curator of the Walter Reed
Museum. Oh. We were just reading about your museum. We got on the topic of elephantiasis, and apparently elephantiasis scroti, to be more precise.
And you have one on display, I understand.
Oh, my goodness. Yes, we do.
Mm-hmm.
We've got one. How about you?
No.
No, I got two.
Do you have anything else that might be of interest to our listeners there?
Thanks for asking, young lady. Of course we do. Several items. And, of course, because we are the official hospital of ex-presidents, we have several items in formaldehyde here.
Such as?
Well, male members of some of the ex-presidents.
What?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
In formaldehyde?
Yeah.
You have Lincoln's...
Lincoln's...
We kind of call it Lincoln's log.
Oh, I thought it might be kind of the ticket that he ran on Lincoln's Johnson.
I'm not in the room.
See, Johnson was his buddy.
His running mate, yeah.
You know, we put the button right there next to the jar.
What about...
How about JFK?
JFK's...
Prodigious would...
Golly.
Well-worn?
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's got two holes.
Two holes?
Could we,
Head was blown up.
Yeah.
Come on.
Is there any way we can settle the phone call?
How about
just pretend there's some kind
say
of
goodbye
staff?
To
how
the
about,
the,
how about Taft? Do you have Taft?
William Howard Taft chode.
I'm sure he is.
Hang on.
He never saw his.
Hang on.
We're out of here. Goodbye.
We don't want to talk to him.
Dallas Cowboys now lost three defensive starters from Super Bowl championship team. Latest to leave is linebacker Dixon Edwards. What a great name. He's agreed to a 4-year contract with the Vikes worth $10 million. Arizona Cardinals have given a 5-year contract to cornerback Aeneas Williams worth $17 million.
Wow, that's unbelievable for a cornerback.
William the Refrigerator Perry will try a comeback with the London Monarchs of the World League. I believe I forget. Who made up nicknames for those?
Yeah.
I forget what London was. Stuffies, I think? London?
London Bridges.
The Barcelona Bolognese.
Barcelona Bolognese.
Yeah,
the,
sure. What do they play? In the spring or the fall?
Next week.
Springtime,
a couple weeks.
You know, it's ridiculous. If you're going to have a minor league football, you might as well have them play in football season.
Scorpions were the talk of the San Francisco Giants and California Angels campsites in Arizona. Giants shortstop Sean Dunston stung twice on the right shoulder. Should be back at practice today. Angels pitcher.
These had to be stunts.
Angels pitcher Jim Abbott found his scorpion
how you do
in
a
shoe.
Stunt with a scorpion.
Is that true?
I think these guys were. Someone probably stuck a scorpion in Abbott's shoe when he wasn't looking.
No, I don't think so. I think it got cold in the desert and they came in to get warm.
I'm with Tom.
These scorpions.
I got nothing.
These guys.
Stop it.
Move on. Just move on.
Now, Mark was a bat boy, weren't you? You were a bat boy. They carried on like that, didn't they? Yeah.
I've seen live snakes put in lockers and
scorpions.
That's always funny.
Scorpions.
He's poisoned. See?
Oh, yeah.
These guys are kind of bored. They're really rich. You know.
They scorpions.
Do a light. Sure, they got nothing else to do.
Okay.
They're readily available out there, aren't they, Christine?
I would imagine, aren't they?
Yeah.
Arizona? Aren't they a little poisonous?
Scorpions?
They make you sick.
They will make you sick.
It's always good, clean fun.
They have to suck the poison out?
You're going to die.
Bad news for you.
That's not a friend.
No,
that's sports.
It is.
Wherever you go, whatever you do, always be a good sport. Christy!
Well, a teacher at St. Coleman High School in Pompano Beach, Florida, arrived at the school Saturday for a session of working on the school yearbook. Much to the teacher's surprise, discovered a bomb in the classroom.
A bomb?
A bomb.
On a Saturday?
On a Saturday.
Wow.
Wow. Voted by the yearbook staff, most likely to go kablooey.
Picture of it right there in the corner, yeah. Mm. Wow. Right there by the seniors.
That's very mean.
That is mean.
We must take a short break. Coming up in a few minutes, we'll be speaking with and hearing from the band Delamitri.
Del.
We'll look forward to that on this, The Bob and Tom Show.
31 at Q95, you're with Bob and Tom. Good morning.
Joining us in the studio, the band Delamitri. They're going to be at World Mardi Gras tonight.
Hello.
And we'll be meeting him and everything in a second. Do we have to do anything else from here? We have to say that we're going to be giving away tickets to see AC/DC and Rod Stewart coming up later on Q95. Throughout the day, we gave some away earlier this morning to Kevin
Rich.
Rich. Congratulations to Kevin. This is total organization. We've got everything down. We're all ready. Once again, good morning. This is the Bob and Tom Show. And Delamitri, the band, has joined us in the studio. Good morning, gentlemen.
Good morning.
How you doing?
You all look a little tired, I know.
Well, we just drove overnight from somewhere. I can't remember where it was. Columbus.
That's old. They all look the same after a while, don't they?
I had a conversation with a taxi driver about being in Cleveland. It confused the hell out of both of us for about 15 minutes in this taxi. I can't understand why he thought it was from Cleveland.
Because we were in Columbus.
Must be here.
It's got to be that Cleveland accent.
Yeah. I grew up in Cleveland.
The taxi driver was from Ghana, so that didn't help.
Now, who's who here again, guys? Can you reintroduce yourselves?
No,
I'm Tom. That's Bob.
Uh-huh.
And Chick's going to come in here because he's your biggest fan. He's behind the glass.
Is Chick Scottish?
No, he's
very Scottish.
Roll to me.
You gonna
come
sing?
On, roll.
You'll be Chick.
I also sing. I'm Chick, yes. Good morning.
Hi. I'm Justin. Sorry, while we're doing the introductions.
Justin?
I'm Andy. Yep. I'm not Andy.
Ian.
He's Andy.
I'm Andy. He's Ian.
Yep. Now, Delamitri is an old friend.
Delamitri is an old friend.
Who is Delamitri? Is it named after someone in particular?
It's a pit boss at the Sands, isn't it, in Vegas, right?
Actually, it's snowing in Vegas.
Yesterday it did.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Fascinating. Yeah, didn't know it ever snowed in Vegas.
You'll notice we're changing the subject here.
Uh-huh. Do you always get which one of you is Dell?
Sometimes. Sometimes. That's the problem with having a really stupid name.
We didn't say it was a stupid name.
No, we like
it. I did, though. I reserve the right to say that.
Okay, sure, and you can.
It's your name.
But
sure.
I think it's a swell
and
name.
You boys have very sensible names.
Sure, we do. We do.
Very utilitarian, sensible.
Yep, just Bob.
Easy to get your mouth around.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. is that a tattoo on your hand there? Or are you?
No, it's to remind me that there's three songs we did last night that were quite dreadful and have to be practiced before tonight.
Wow.
I smell a band meeting.
No, it's just,
We never have band meetings.
Never?
No. Never understood the concept.
Did Dell used to have band meetings? Is that why he's
before they kicked him out of the band?
Unspoken?
We don't like to talk about it.
Okay.
Where are you guys from?
Glasgow in Scotland.
I mean,
very like Cleveland, actually.
I've been there.
To Cleveland?
To both.
You've been to Glasgow?
Yeah.
What on earth were you doing in Glasgow?
Hmm?
What on earth were you doing there?
Visiting. It was 20 years ago, but I was there. I'm an old man. It was great. It was fun.
Youthful Folly.
Yes, yeah. It was Youthful Folly. Well, oddly enough, that was the band's name before Dell came up with it. Let's call it.
These guys are tired. Let's let them play.
Alrighty.
I agree.
You guys want to do a tune for us?
Yes, we'll do a tired tune.
Okay, can I ask him not to do the one written on his hand? Because
evidently you don't do that
one. It's actually one of the ones written on the hand.
That was dreadful last night.
Consider this a practice.
You can do a practice right here.
But the bass player's not here, so it can't sound that bad.
Alright.
This is called Tell All This. Tell her not to go.
from time to time. Tell her not to cry. I just got scared, that's all. Tell her I'll be by her side. All she has to do is call. All she has to do is call. Tell her the chips are down. And shouted it aloud. Tell her something in my heart needs her more than even clowns need the laughter of the crowd. Tell her what was wrong. I sometimes think too much but say nothing at all. Tell her from this high terrain I am ready now to fall. This. All I want to do is kiss her. Tell her something in my mind freezes up from time to time.
Excellent. That was great.
Bravo. Dell'Amitri in the studio, and I know you guys don't usually sing this early in the morning, so we certainly appreciate your getting up.
Usually trying to avoid it.
We choose not to.
You sound great. It's so funny. I don't hope this doesn't come out wrong, but when you sing, you don't have the accent. Not that there's anything wrong with it. You have a lovely speaking voice. It's just
there is a technical reason for this. Apart from the Proclaimers who do sing in Scottish accents.
You remember the Proclaimers? They were one of the, they sort of.
I will walk 10,000 miles.
Sure.
I mean, they absolutely went for singing in broad Scottish accents.
But the problem with the Scottish accent is that it's all consonants and no vowels. So it's all, I will walk 10,000. It's really hard to sing consonants. It's like singing the bee and Bob.
Well, even the Beatles, if you think about the Beatles songs, every once in a while they do something where they put some word in.
It was only after they took lots of drugs they started to sing in Liverpool accents again.
Yeah.
I think that says something.
Yeah, it's sort of like TV newsmen. I don't know.
Well, if they take lots of drugs, they start reading the news in Liverpool accents.
You guys have been all over America, and I don't know if you ever watch any local news, but it's always a hoot. You go down to Dallas, Texas, and the news guy comes out. He talks just like I do.
He should have a Texas drawl, but he
never walks on and goes, "You won't believe it happened today, boys." It doesn't. It just when you're saying it comes out nice and clean.
We have that. You get that in Britain as well. It's something called received pronunciation, which actually just makes you sound like a posh toff. And if you tune into Birmingham or Liverpool news, it's the same thing. It's received pronunciation. It's not actually.
Yeah, that's interesting. Well, yeah, here they call it broadcast English, I think.
Broadcast English.
Sort of generic. And I'm proud to say that that's how I talk.
Flat. No inflection.
You guys talk so. It's so beautiful to hear you speak. Tell us a little bit about the band. You're on a tour. You've been on tour forever?
Yeah. Yes.
Anxious to get home?
Well, we had January off in our various different homes. We don't all live in one home.
You didn't go back to... You went back to Scotland for January?
Yes, we did.
Well, I don't know much about it, but it's probably
a little cold, isn't it?
Great time of year up there, huh?
Well, I'd like to repeat this very boring statistic, which I repeat very often, which is that Glasgow is the warmest place in Europe in February.
Oh.
See, we have this thing where all
the warmest place. Well,
the Gulf Stream comes up from the Gulf of Mexico, okay, and sort of keeps us warm and wet. Mm-hmm. Rains a lot.
Oh, so it's kind of like Seattle. Get out the heroin and just kill yourself in February. the annual depressing festival.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Not that it's real pretty here. Where have you been in the States so far? Everywhere?
Everywhere. Pretty much everywhere, yeah.
We were in Blacksburg, Virginia the other day.
Allentown. We were in the other
Allentown?
Day.
Mm-hmm. Great place, great place.
Lovely.
what's your favorite spot?
We like Chicago and New York and San Francisco.
Okay, big cities.
Mm-hmm. I mean, being Europeans, you just become accustomed to big cities. You feel mm-hmm. a bit sort of lost if you're in some place where you can't just go out and stop a taxi.
Yeah. Yeah, well, you can't stop one here.
If you have a gun, you can always stop a taxi.
Well, exactly.
If you can find one.
How's the new records doing well for you guys?
Yeah.
I know we're playing it. Mm-hmm. Do you want to play another tune for us now? You have the energy? Can you do one more?
Well, we do have a minor technical problem in that we lost our tuner.
Oh, we got
a tuner.
We've got everything you need.
Hey, Butler, if you could bring me...
Why don't we take a break?
All right, we'll let you
tune. Let you guys tune, and maybe a couple ounces of coffee, and we'll come right back and do another one. Is that
fair
okay
enough.
With you?
All right.
Great. Well, thanks. We're speaking with Delamitri. We're going to take a short break and come right back with another song.
We think. Anything. I said nothing. Sorry, we're having a band meeting.
Okay. Oh, it's about time. This is the Bob and Tom Show.
From the top of the charts.
9:45 at Q95. You're with Bob and Tom. Good morning.
Hello. Delamitri, the band, is in the studio. They're playing tonight at World Mardi Gras downtown. And we're going to be speaking with them, and they're doing kind of a tuning-up thing right now. We ambushed them with a request for another song.
Mm-hmm.
But they're being very polite and nice about it now.
On your head, be it.
Fine.
It could be a disaster. Now, remember what Ian said about those things written on his hand? This could be another one of them.
Okay, this is the Bob and Tom program. And we have Justin, Randy, and Ian. Am I getting that right? Andy.
Randy's
Andy.
Much better.
Randy Alston.
Now, see, I had a...
Now you've given him a nickname. Perfect.
Well, see, I had a... I blew that because a friend of mine is named Randy, and he went to England where my sister lives. And Randy over there is the equivalent of being named Horny over here. Yeah. If you're Randy in England, it means you're... So I'm not implying that although you've been on a bus with these two guys for a pretty long time, you're getting Randy, Andy.
Not right now. You must understand that the artist Randy Van Warmer had a totally different meaning in Britain.
Oh, yeah. I remember that guy.
I guess it would.
I don't remember anybody called Randy Van Warmer.
Oh, sure,
Van
Warmer.
Randy Van Warmer.
Music, but just the name.
I'd like to hear him say,
Randy Van Warmer. Mm-hmm. That's right.
Is that the Scottish version?
I'm trying.
I was pathetic.
Can you?
I know.
What are some of the? Who are some other famous Scottish artists that everyone's familiar with?
I mean, there's like Nazareth and
Nazareth.
Rod Stewart.
Rod.
Well, Rod Stewart pretends to be Scottish, but he's not really.
He wasn't born in Scotland.
Yeah.
That's sort of AC/DC from Scotland as well. From like Australia, sort of via Scotland or Scotland via Australia.
I don't know. But these guys are from Scotland, and they're just getting going. They've got some great songs. And
what about the Bay City Rollers?
Of course, the Bay City Rollers.
We used to do a cover of Shang-A-Lang by the Bay City Rollers. A very good one as well. We had tartan flares and everything.
Wow. Are they still out there? Are they doing like the monkey?
They are.
There's now two versions, yeah. They sort of fell out on the Bay City Rollers and Les McEwen's Bay City Rollers, who every Hogmanay, which is New Year's Eve, are like booked all across Scotland. They'll do like three shows. They sort of play them one after the other.
Wow.
See, stuff out there is weird,
isn't
it?
That's great.
But see, you've got, there's that other band that's
Foghat.
They're English, though, I think.
Foghat.
Yeah.
Then you've got Foghat and you've got Lonesome Dave's Foghat.
And they had the same thing. So that happens everywhere.
Must be very confusing.
And there's that Canadian band, The Guess Who. I think they're touring with the original Sound Man. I'm not sure anyone ever played in that band anymore. Mm-hmm. Maybe it's the drummer. Who knows?
Well, people used to always say that we sounded like the Guess Who, and then I went out and bought a Guess Who album, and it was quite appalled. But
that was not a compliment, was it?
Not as far as I'm concerned. The Guess Why?
Maybe they meant the Who.
I don't think so.
Is that thing? You got that thing tuned up? You're pretty happy with it? You want to do a little sound check? Or are you guys pretty much?
Oh, we'll go for it. This could be
okay. What song is this?
Well, this is a song called "Always the Last to Know."
Oh, this is a great song.
Yeah, indeed. Okay, so I'll just start on A then. Okay. 2, 3, 4.
love with someone else, someone who burns within your soul. And it looks like I am the last to know. I hear you've never felt so alive, so much desire beyond control. And as usual, I am the last to know. The last to know how you're feeling. The last to know where you are. The last to know if you're happy now, or if he's treating you like I treated you, or if he's cruel. I'll be the last to know. So we spent summers out beyond the bay, and you said these are such perfect days, that if the bomb drops, baby, I wanna be the last to know. But now you're living up behind the hill, and though we share the same city and feel the same sun, when your winter comes, I'll be the last to know. Always the last to know how you're feeling. The last to know where you are. The last to know if you're happy now, or if he's pleading with you like I pleaded with you. If you go, don't let me be the last to know. Don't let me be the last to know. Creation's gone crazy, the TV's gone mad. Now you're the only sane thing that I have. The last to know where you are. The last to know if you're happy now, or if he's cheating on you like I cheated on you. Oh, and you were the last to know. You were the last to know. Don't let me be the last.
That was great.
That was what's known in Scotland as a makey uppy.
You did fine. You turned a little red on the very end. That last note.
It's a little bit.
I was just singing through all that phlegm, that morning phlegm.
The last to note. That was wonderful, though. Dellamitri, thanks, guys. I know it's hard for you to sing this really, but you sound great.
Thank you.
And we certainly enjoy your records. Mm-hmm. Are we... fixing to take a break?
Or we can do whatever you want.
Should we do a little dick joke fest?
Not necessary.
I thought you guys might be getting lonesome on the road and need a little humor for the duration. When do you guys usually sleep? All day long?
Yeah, usually. I usually try and get up about 4.
Yeah.
It didn't quite happen this morning, though.
Well, you still have time to go.
So are you guys broadcasting any different time zones?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, well, maybe. That made me feel better. Anywhere west of here?
Yeah, west of here. So it's 7 someplace else. So right now you're doing okay.
But nowhere east of here. That's a shame.
We're
east of here also.
Oh, yeah. We're everywhere.
We're everywhere.
But you're not in a different time zone east of here, though, are you?
No, well, yeah, if you're...
Unless you're broadcast to the Ascension Islands.
Or to Dildo.
Dildo.
That's Dildo, Newfoundland. Atlantic, yeah.
There isn't really a place called Dildo.
Yes, there is. Look, there's a t-shirt.
There's a t-shirt right
Dildo
there.
Dildo Day celebration.
Must we play it for them?
That's Captain Dildo right there.
That's really very unfortunate.
We're in a place, there's a place called Virginville. And right next to Virginville is a town called Intercourse. I absolutely
see that's in Pennsylvania.
Yeah,
sure.
Oh, yeah.
I couldn't believe that.
We also, we have toured Germany as well, but it's probably best not to mention some of the towns in Germany.
Probably not.
All okay, right.
I'll play a little song here, a tribute to the city of Dildo, Newfoundland.
Okay, guys, so
if
we'll...
You're, it's about
it's
the
a real
famous
place.
Sea captain, Captain Dildo. You ready?
Here we are.
In a faraway land near St. John's lies the rugged seaport of Dildo, Newfoundland. Dildo, deeply penetrating the eastern coast of Canada, is known far and wide as the birthplace of legendary seaman Captain Dildo.
Captain Dildo is his name, the sailor we've all heard about in some exotic port. He's always pulling in and out. He's laid out a code to which he subscribes, spreading peace and love and giving us good vibes. Captain Dildo, Captain Dildo, Captain Dildo.
There's Captain Dildo heading out to sea.
Gosh, I wish I was going with him.
You will someday. And remember what they say. You can take a woman out of Dildo, but you can't take the dildo out of a woman.
He sails the seven seas, a purple helmet on his head. He's legendary for the many tales that he has spread. Who needs a mortal man? Why become annoyed? Call on Captain Dildo. He will fill the void. Captain Dildo, Captain Dildo, Captain Dildo, Captain Dildo, yo ho!
And as long as Captain Dildo's around, there will always be a little dildo in all of us.
Short and sweet.
Going to the Atlantic time zone briefly.
That's art.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, in Britain, we have a thing called innuendo. That was just out-uendo. I mean, that wasn't even subtle.
It's a real place, Justin. Thanks to the guys from Delamute. You were taking a break. This is the Bob and Tom Show.
There's popcorn in your mailbox.
That's right.
Popcorn. Check your mail.
295, you're with Bob and Tom. Good morning.
Good morning. This portion of our program sponsored by...
Acip Optometry. Think you couldn't? Well, you can.
It's youthful folly.
We can, doctor, that is.
You can't see, man.
You know, Justin Delamitri told me that my Scottish accent's pathetic.
He's right.
Pathetic.
But wasn't it nice hearing him say it?
It was nice hearing him say it. It was even nicer hearing them play it. And I could see them clearly with my Acip glasses. Yes, that's it. Acip. Can you wear contacts? Sure you can, even if you've got astigmatism or wear bifocals. Acip's got designer eyewear, but they're just really big. No, they're really, they're actually...
I've got glasses, too.
Actually, actual conventional size contacts. Some soft, some hard. Call old Doc Acip in Broad Ripple, 257-5421. Free parking on the side of the big old green building.
And if you bust him, take him in, they fix him.
Thank you very much, Jim. Good morning. This is the Bob and Tom Show.
Hi.
This is the Dick's Picks portion of our program.
I saw the Dickster in the hallway.
Okay, thanks again to the guys from Delamitri for stopping by.
Mm-hmm.
They got a great album out there.
Very cool.
And if you happen to be if you happen to be in Indianapolis tonight, there at the World Mardi Gras.
Right.
It's a good club. I was there Saturday night.
Right. So look for them in person.
Saw the Badleys, didn't you?
Mm-hmm.
Kinda.
Another nice band.
Mm-hmm.
Friends of the show.
Mm-hmm. We were backstage.
Backstage. Oh, that's where we saw the band.
Tell me I ain't a rock and roller. Bub.
Who went home at 10:30?
Bub.
Rock and roller.
You went home before I did.
10:25.
All right, girls.
No, it is it's time now for the Dick's Picks portion of our program. We're spent.
Well, I was hoping that we'd have a musical guest.
Well, we did. And they've already come and gone.
Well, I was there's a new band working. They're called Adolf Hitler and the Imperials.
Mm-hmm.
And I was going to bring them in and have them do a few of their hit songs.
They do the Tighten Up, don't they?
They do a Tighten Up like you wouldn't believe. They make Archie Bell and the Drells sound sick the way they do that.
We dance as good as we conquer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We can dance just as good as we invade.
It's really funny, though. Adolf Hitler and the Imperials, they toured Poland and only took 6 days.
Is that right?
They just kind of shut it down. And then they overran France.
They tore it up, didn't they? They tore it up.
They tore it up. They overran France, and then it was really difficult. They kind of had a niche market in North Africa and Italy.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't want to talk about the touring habits of Adolf Hitler and the Imperials.
When they tried to go to Britain, they were repelled at the shore. And then they were a brief hit in Russia, but that didn't last long either.
Mm-hmm. Really, the only place they were popular was Germany.
The deserts of South Africa.
They did pretty well in South Africa, Italy. A lot of sold-out shows in the fatherland.
Mm-hmm.
But... And the band really only stayed together for 5 years.
Is this your way of saying that you don't have a topic for
the tradition is you burn your ticket after you go in.
Yeah.
Is this your way of
What you do is you disavow any knowledge of attending an Adolf Hitler and the Imperials concert.
I see. Uh-huh.
Even the road manager later claimed he was only doing it under the orders of Adolf.
Towards the end, you know, the popularity was waning. They really only played bunkers.
You know, I remember their last CD, The Bunker, which I thought was absolutely terrific. It was kind of like a little bit like Lou Reed's Berlin album. It was very sparse.
Mm-hmm.
It had a very eerie feel to it.
I thought it was like Pet Sounds a little bit.
Pet Sounds, sure.
Ava Braun doing background vocals.
Exactly. That's
That was one produced by Albert Speer. Well,
yes. Albert Speer.
Well, since he started, we might as well finish
this
it.
This is a public notice.
Attention Nazis. Attention Nazis.
If you were a camp worker, Wehrmacht regular, or an officer in the SS, and you served your Führer between the years 1936 to 1945, you are eligible for pension benefits.
Thanks to the National Association of National Socialist Financial Services Group and due to the recent discovery of a hidden Nazi treasure trove, pension benefit plans have been reinstated for former Nazis.
Yes, Hitler said the Third Reich would last 1,000 years. Okay, so he only gave it a good 9.5. But here's a testimonial from one of our happy recipients.
I thought when I fled Germany in 1945 that my pension plan had been dismissed. But thanks to the National Association of National Socialists, I can buy food again. I can get my boots polished. I can get that bifocal monocle I've always been dying for.
Clink, you idiot. You know, when they reinstated my Wehrmacht pension, I was actually able to buy a small plot of land and a nice condo.
Yes, of course, General Burkhalter, of course, you're high Hitler.
Remember, if you served the fatherland from 1936 to 1945, you can't be turned down for any reason.
For more information, write National Association of National Socialists, P.O. Box SS-1000, Skokie, Illinois, 1086. Or phone 1-800-NAZI-BUCKS. That's 1-800-NAZI-BUCKS.
Outside the continental United States, phone 1-800-NO-HABLA-DEUTSCH. Do it. Rouse.
All right.
Tribute.
There we are.
We'd like to salute our good friends from Argentina.
I didn't know we had
any friends. And Brazil.
Okay.
Fine. So, they're on the network this morning, and that's where a lot of Nazi guys left shortly at the end of the conflict back in 1940.
We just, really...
You know, this show used to cater, I think, to neo-Nazis.
I don't think we do. At one point.
No, really.
No interest in Nazis of any kind. Nope. You are just a psychopath, and I don't know why you're obsessed with them. And why...
You know, the thing is, perhaps...
Can we get out of the Dick Pick Show in our next contract? Isn't there a way we could leave the room at 10 like every other radio personality in America?
I was going to tell you
10
guys.
10 o'clock, you're done. I mean, you go do your work, prep for the next day. We've been fighting the comedy wars for 4 hours, and now...
Oh, man, have we.
Now here we are with Dick.
It's been rough. It's been in the trenches. Who used mustard gas?
I did.
Okay.
Who jumped on that dick joke grenade? Stop that.
See, we're out there all morning long slogging away. And all of a
there you are. You're in the trenches.
Nazi man here.
Yeah.
Nazi man.
I was just going to say, Tom, you may enjoy my new historical novel.
I doubt it.
Heinrich Himmler, not such a bad guy once you get to know him.
Yeah, he wasn't a bad
I'll
guy.
Pass.
He really wasn't.
He had a family.
Know, sure, he was the architect of the Third Reich, but so many people... Forgot to look at the humanitarian side.
There was no humanitarian side.
And
why don't you pick this up on your show?
You should have seen.
I have a meeting to go to.
Say what you will about Nazis, but the company picnic wasn't really that bad.
I tell you, they had
a hell of a dental plan, too.
They had a hell of a dental
plan. Oh, yeah.
In fact, that's how they had to identify Hitler's body through dental records. So thank God they had a good dental plan there in the Third Reich.
Mm-hmm.
The three-legged race and the sack race and hide-and-go-seek in the bunker.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me that
was a delicious German potato salad. Wow. Not good.
And the thing is, the difference between German potato salad and American potato salad, German potato salad is commonly served warm.
Mm-hmm.
And great bratwurst, sauerkraut,
fine.
And who amongst us has not had a beer?
Yeah, and we owe the lager beer to our good friends in the fatherland.
Darn right.
So every time you hoist a beer...
I've never referred to it as the fatherland.
Yeah, not my father. Now, if we could change the subject, we have a we have an album to come out with, mercifully. And we're looking for a title. We have received many dozens, hundreds, in fact, of faxes.
Right.
So we're going to ask you once again today to waste your time at the office if you go to one or go to a fax place and fax us your suggestions.
What are you leaning towards at this point, Tom?
We're leaning toward the album title Bob and Tom Present Factory Air.
I like that.
Yeah, it's got air in it, like being on the air. And then factory air is a slang term, first off, for air conditioning in an automobile from the 60s. It was a big thing to have a car with factory air.
Right, exactly.
Meaning it was an air conditioner that had been installed as the car was built at the factory.
The illustration would be very cool. I can always already see you guys in a car or something.
Mm-hmm. Now,
I don't think that'd be it.
Probably wouldn't be it.
In front of Frigamall Industries with a big belching smoke cloud up in the air.
Factory air.
The other meaning of factory air is a slang term.
Right.
And we've had several people tell us that there are a lot of places to see this, particularly the Farrah Fawcett issue of Playboy, apparently. There's quite a good factory air.
Oh, yeah.
It's apparently a condition, a physical attribute, if you will, in which a particularly fit woman can stand up, and from the back or the front, there's actually air at the top of her thighs.
This would be considered, like, good, though, wouldn't it?
When wearing a bikini.
That would be a desirable trait.
That would be a desirable
factory
trait.
Factory air.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Yes, a lot of, if women have that, is considered that it's the beginning of perfect legs.
Yes. Factory.
I see. Mm-hmm. See, I guess I never thought of it along those lines.
Did you tell him the other part about the back of the album? What we were
Well, we were considering actually having some sort of a contest to determine. And we'd have to have a photograph, have the credits on the back side of the CD over a picture of a woman with factory air.
Mm-hmm.
But we'd have to find the perfect.
We'd have to have like a factory air contest.
Exactly.
Auditions.
You know, I was thinking, I think what would be kind of fun is, you know, you guys have always used top flight artists to do the covers.
Mm-hmm.
Why don't we have a chimp paint the back cover of the Bob and Tom album? You know, because they do that thing, you know, where they give the monkey the temper paints.
Uh-huh.
That would be spectacular. Have a chimp actually paint.
Do they sell monkeys around here anywhere?
I want a monkey. I will have a monkey.
No, you won't.
You know, our good friend...
I hope you get one, because when you do, I'll have a perfect excuse never to come back in here.
You know, our good friend Mr. G said that he found a place where they actually breed monkeys here.
Yeah?
One thing... See, I remember having a monkey as a child. Can I tell you about my monkey as a child?
Sorry. No.
You can't have a monkey, and you're not going to talk about monkeys.
My uncle...
Come on, just a little monkey.
My uncle... Can I just talk just a little bit about Tom? Because I think you'll find the story illuminating.
No, I won't.
My uncle was a circus performer. Uh-huh. He started as a roustabout, then worked his way up to carny.
Wow.
And he was going to Barker School when his carnival shut down.
Mm-hmm.
I think you know, because he was going to bark for the yak woman.
Sure he was.
And, you know,
well, he still had a couple months to go.
Sure, he had a couple more. You know, the thing is, it was a study at home thing, and that Barker School went belly up. But I'm digressing here. But one of the things that he learned from being in the circus, you know, is that they would commonly keep monkeys as pets. And I remember getting a type of fever that lasted over 12 weeks just from coming in contact with this little monkey. I remember being in a darkened room, shivering uncontrollably, wishing I could die. And then for some unknown reason...
I wish I was there right now.
Man, childhood memories.
No, I wish he was there right now.
For some unknown reason, that fever just broke and I was fine. But, you know, my uncle had a very interesting life.
Well, why don't you write a book about it?
He had an eagle tattooed on his forehead.
Purchase it and tell you what I read it.
Wasn't his autobiography called Monkey Shoes?
Yeah, it was Monkey Shoes. And you know, there's something about seeing those little fellers perform in the oversized shoes on a tricycle.
I like them when their feet are crammed in little shoes that are too small for them.
Sometimes
I like
that's
them when
good
they're dressed
well.
Up in clothes pushing a baby button. Yeah, I like
oh,
that.
Dear. That music
that
means we have to go.
Time for the Man, is it that time already? Wow. Brought to you by...
You know, that's what America needs is a good monkey show. Just chimps dressed up in adorable little costumes.
Well, the way this is going, we're going to have one hosting from 10 to 10:20.
Tom, how do you really feel about it? Because
don't sugarcoat it.
Do you want to hear about the yak woman?
Jack's tools, what I want to hear about.
A new snorkel lift, 72 feet.
What quality made her a yak woman, though? Was it like a protruding horn?
Face?
I think the face. The face was really...
Yeah.